So first of all, we'll see how to start the server, means how to log into the Pega application. Okay, so I told you, so once installation is done, so on the desktop Pega will create three icons here. So one is login icon, shutdown icon and startup icon. So first thing we need to do is click on startup. So it will start the server, and the server is a Tomcat server by default, it will install. And here no need to connect to any external server, so directly within our system only. So Pega will provide intranet server here. Okay, so directly we'll start the server here. Okay, mute your microphone server. So we need to start the server, so which is intranet server, so just click on the startup icon, it will start automatically. Okay, it will open two command prompts here. So once server is started, we will get a message. So we can log into the application using the login icon. Okay. So once the server is started, so we need to click on login icon. Again, Pega will have a default user ID and password. We need to enter the details. So, administrator. Iqbal, mute your microphones, please. Administrator@pega.com. And password is INSTALL is the password. Okay, so login to this application using the default user ID and password. Okay, the server is still starting. So once server is started, we can enter the details. I will take at the end of the session or in the... So wait for something. So in the server, excuse me. So when we start the server, so database also will start automatically. Okay, no need to manually configure database here. So I told you, along with the server, it will also configure database in this backend. So again, there is no need to manually start the database here. So when you log into the application, so automatically database also will start. Okay, so now the server is started. So when you get this last message, server start up in milliseconds, so we can log into the application now. Just click on the login icon. and enter this user ID and password. So which is a default user ID and default password. INSTA double LS password. Just log into the application. And Pega supports all browsers. Okay, you can open the application in any browser, but recommended is Internet Explorer is a recommended browser. Okay, so even though it will open in Chrome or other browsers, Mozilla, Safari, other browsers, so the recommended one is Internet Explorer is most recommended. So once we log into the application, so why we need to log into the default ID means, so we need to, suppose if you want to start building a new application, so in order to start a new project or new application, so we need to create an application setup, some configuration we need to do, means we need to enter the details, means so we need to enter the name of the applications, organization, module names, so all that information. So compulsory we require one login ID is required. So in that login setup only we can configure a new application. So whenever you want to start a new project, so compulsory, because if you install the software for the first time, you will not have any other operator IDs. So this is the only operator ID where you can log into the application. So from this ID, you can start creating a new setup. Okay. And in order to create a new application setup, Pega internally will have some tools. So internally Pega will provide some tools for building new applications. Okay, and the tool name is called as DCO tool, and full form is Direct Capture of Objectives. And inside this tool, DCO tool, so again we have one more configuration, and the tool name is called as Application Express. Actually, so inside DCO is the main tool, again inside that, for entering all the details and in order to do the configuration, so the other tool name is Application Express. So using these two means, so DCO is the main page, and inside that we have another tool called Application Express. So using this we will build new applications. Okay, anytime if you want to, not only this application, any application if you want to develop, so this is the default tool we have to, so enter all the details in this, then configure the process and enter all the details, so automatically Pega will configure the application for you. So the total setup will happen in the back end. So only thing is we need to enter the details, like, so I will show in the next session about this. So what are the details it will ask, so like application names, organization names, objectives, modules in the application, so all that information we will enter. Okay, automatically so Pega only will configure the process in the back end, and as part of the application setup process, Pega will create different portals. Okay, it is going to create different portals for us. So in 7 version we have 3 different portals will be there. Admin or developer portal, excuse me. Admin or developer portal, manager portal, and user portal. Okay, these three IDs and these three portals it will generate, so as part of the application setup. So based on this, so normally if you want to do the development and everything, so we log into admin or developer portal. Manager will log into manager portal, so for managing the entire application, means so in order to monitor the application and monitor the cases and monitor the modules, so they'll use the user, you'll use the manager portal. Okay, so in this development will not happen, only application monitoring will happen. And user portal, so it is used for assigning the task to the developers. Okay, so for end user purpose or assigning the task to the developers, they'll use the user portal. Okay, so these two portals will look similar, but the access will be different for manager portal and user portal. Okay, and admin portal will be, so it will look like this. So it is nothing but a admin or developer portal. But in the previous versions, okay, this setup and these tools are from whatever I'm saying, right? So from 7.1 version. But if you take a previous version, slight different will be there. So tools, tool DCO is same, but inside the DCO, so what are the tools used for application setup are different from 7.1 version. Okay, and also in 6. Previous version, it will create 5 different portals. Okay, 5 different portals will be there in previous version, but in the current version only, so they config, means they reduced the portals and everything they configured in a single thing. Okay, admin and developer portal made as this one is single one, but in the previous version, so there will be 2 different portals will be there. Okay, so here manager portal and user portal are common from the 6.3 version. Okay, and when we compare some other features and other options, so many look and feel wise, the total tool is changed from previous version to the current version, and also few options are included in the 7.1 version. Okay, so that like more majorly some maximum 5 to 10 features are changed. Okay, so the overall concept of the tool is same. Okay, so concept wise there is no change, the rules are common, everything is common, but few settings and few controls has been modified in the latest version. Okay, so that's apart from that, so in every version the process and concept will be same. Okay, so if you learn one version, it will automatically can work on any other version. Okay, but don't worry, so maximum all the companies are using 7.1, and some few companies like 10% or 15% of the companies, in order to work on the maintenance projects or support projects, so they will use 6.3 also. Okay, so automatically if you learn 7.1, and I will show the 6.3 version also in one or two sessions, so what are the differences we have between both the versions, then you can learn, you can work on both the versions. Okay, that is not an issue. Now coming to the tool, so the entire tool contains different panels. So first of all, they divide the total page into different panels. Okay, this thing is called as, so this overall thing is a platform. So whatever you are seeing when we log into the application is nothing but a platform. So this total platform we can also call it as, so PRPC platform or portal, or we can also call it as Designer Studio. Okay, so if I use any of these names, so both are same only, PRPC portal or Designer Studio or platform, which is used for designing the applications. Okay, so for designing new rules, modifying any rule, so in order to develop any new thing inside the application, so we will use PRPC portal or Designer Studio. Okay, so now this total PRPC portal is divided into different panels. Okay, so header panel, explorer panel, this is footer panel, and this is a work panel. Okay, so overall there will be 4 types of panels will be there. And inside that, so under each panel will have different options. So header panel contains some menu options will be there, menu bars will be there. Then explorer panel contains all explorers, different types of explorers will be there. Work panel contains, so whatever we open, it will open inside the work panel. So where we can modify, we can add things, so we can add the, we can generate new things in the application. So work panel, whatever we open from the any menu or menu, any explorer, everything will open in a work panel. And then footer panel or toolbar panel. Okay, so overall page is divided into these four parts. So coming to the components, or what are the options we have inside the header here. So header contains different types of, all the menu bars will be there. Okay, this is one menu bar, this is one menu bar. Okay, this is Business Studio menu bar, this is application menu bar, launch menu bar, create menu, search option for searching for any rule in the application. So this is like a version control tool, like if you want, end user want to check in or check out, so all the history will be maintained by taking the control of the rules, accessing the rules. So everything comes under private. And then recent menu, so what are the things recently opened, we can check from here, or directly we can navigate from the recent menu. And this is help menu, so contains all the information related to Pega topics. So any information on any of the topic inside this Pega tool or inside the Pega PRPC, so from the help menu we can access. And operator menu, so operator menu contains, so the operator ID information is nothing but user information or developer information will be there from the operator menu. So like this. So coming to in detail, so if you go to the designer menu or business studio menu, so many like wizards will be there, means so many internally tools will be there. So application documentation tools, deployment tools, okay, data table configuration tools, reporting tools, integration tools, so all these things comes on most of the wizards. All the wizards will be added in this Designer Studio menu. Okay, so by topic wise topic, so we'll be covering all the, what are the things we have inside this, what are all the tools or wizards we have inside this menu bar, we'll cover in the sessions. Okay, so importantly, so under this we have application documentation and deployment tools, and data table generation tools, then integration wizards, so all the connector configuration wizards, service configuration wizards, in email configuration wizards, resource configuration, so all these things comes under the integration category. Okay, so which is very important. So when we work on the applications, we mostly use the Designer Studio menu bar. Next here we can see is application menu. So your application information means what is the name of the application. Okay, so you can see here Pega rules is the default application name in the, so default operator ID. Okay, when you configure a new application, right, that new application name will be displayed here. And if you click on that menu, you can see the application information. And generally from this default operator ID, see, we can create a new application setup, means if you want to start building a new project, from here only we'll create a setup. So we have a new application option, right? So I told you internally Pega contains some tools, DCBo tool and Application Express. So those tools we have to navigate from here. So if you go to this application menu, so when you go to this submenu called new application, from here we can start creating a new application setup. Okay, so new application setup can be done from this application menu only. So this option, this configuration we will do in the next session. Next is launch menu. So launch menu is this nothing but launching different portals. Okay, so I told you we have three different types of portals are there. Currently we are in the admin or developer portal. Okay, if you want to log into other portal like manager portal, okay, actually this user is having access to admin portal and manager portal. Suppose if you want to access the manager portal, so without logging from this ID, so directly he can click on the manager portal and it will open the portal automatically. And this is create is nothing but testing a case, means so in the application we'll be adding different modules. So anytime if you want to test the module Okay, so basic testing if you want to perform. From here we can run our modules in the application. Okay, here it is showing two cases. So about this cases information I'll tell you in tomorrow session you'll get. So how to add the cases and how they will get populated in the create option. So how to test them in the application you'll get in the coming sessions. So create is nothing but in order to test your module in the application. So from here just click on that option, it will display the what are the configuration we have added in that particular case. It will show step by step. Okay, so about this one you'll get in tomorrow's session. And search is for searching a rule, I told you. And this is for check-in control, check-in and check-out control tool will be there. So means whenever end user, whenever the developer accessing any rule, right? So that particular rule will be in the control of that user. So again, so once after completing the work, he can click on check-in option. So like this, so there will be check-in and check-out control tool will be there. So that one I'll show in the next sessions. And this is recently viewed items and help menu. And apart from that, we have operator menu. So operator menu contains information about this particular developer. Okay, currently we are logging with the default ID. So if you want to see, so what is the particular operator access, means what is the name of the operator and operator information. If you click on this operator, it will show so to which application is having access. So apart from this application, so he is also having access to other applications also. So those information, application access information and name of the operator and all those things he can update in this operator option. Okay, so email IDs, operator IDs, names, application access and all you can set from here. In the work option, some routing option will be there. So that one I'll tell you in the coming sessions. So he is having access to organization currently. Pega.com is the organization right now. And in the security, so if they want to update any passwords or anything, so the default password is installed, right? So if they want to update, they can update from the security option. So anyway, these things we'll do in the coming sessions also. So just I'm showing. Next is inside the operator menu, there will be something called access group. So access group means nothing but what level of access this particular operator is having to the application. Okay, so access group nothing but the level of access the particular developer is having to the application means, okay, basically he's having access to this Pega rules application right now. And inside this Pega rules, actually, so all the people, all the developers in the application will not have access to all the portals. Okay, some developers will have only access to developer portal, other developers may have access to manager portal and user portal. Okay, so currently this operator is having access to two different portals because application contains portals. Okay, again, apart from the portals, there will be roles will be there. Okay, so there will be roles. So roles will be like, so again these roles also based on the developer experience or seniority in the organization. So these roles will be same, means so based on the roles only he can access the things inside the application. Okay, so here we can see, so different types of roles like sysadmin 4 is a basic administration access, like a basic developer access is nothing but sysadmin 4. And multi-tenant admin is a basic admin access, and security administrator is a medium administration access, and high availability administrator is a high-end admin access. Okay, suppose these roles will be not common for all the developers. Okay, so few developers will have access to only this one, sysadmin 4 only, and some other developers who is seniors more than the, like, so at least 3 or 4 years experience, they will also get access to multi-tenant admin also. So team leaders and other positions will be there, right? So they will get also access to security and high availability administrator. So like this, so based on the position in the organization, so they will be getting these roles. Okay, so based on these roles they can access the few things inside the application. So like this, So they will, the business analyst people will be there. They will be setting all these roles. So what type of application access you have. So all those things they can set from the access group information. Okay. So when they create operate ready, right? So at operate ready level only, they can set all this access for each and every developer. Okay. So for every developer, they'll create a separate ID and they'll give access. What level of access he can access in the application. So what are the things he can access inside the application. So all those things they will define inside the access group. So accordingly, he can access the what are the things in the application, means whatever he can access. So based on these roles only he can access. Okay. So that one. So in the operator ID creation, I'll tell you. Okay. These are all the options we'll get in the header option. And again we have a explorer panel. Okay, or this is nothing but a explorer panel. So we can see different types of explorers here, and few things are again common from the header panel. So that is recent is common and private is common from the header panel. Okay, already we have the recent and private from the header panel. Again they included in the explorer panel also. And we have something called cases explorer. Okay, so I told you when we define the application setup, Pega will configure, means we'll give the module names. So automatically, so from the cases explorer we'll configure the case names. So from this the workflow design will be done, means the flow design, like workflow diagrams will be there. So all that configuration will start from the case. So that one also I will show in tomorrow session, because in a default operator ready we cannot create any cases here. So when we generate a new application, then I'll show you how to configure these cases. And data explorer, so it is nothing but same as whenever we generate any tables in the application, so all the table names and information you can view from the data explorer. Okay, so data tables information we can access from the data explorer. And application explorer, so it is very important. So inside this application, what are the things you want to create, right? So any new things or any new rules you want to generate inside the application will be defining from the application explorer only. Okay, so all the new rules from this application will be configured from this application explorer. Okay, so we'll be having classes and different types of rule types. Again under the rule types we'll be having all the rules. Okay, so we'll be learning all these things inside the application, means how to define these rules and how to configure them in the application. So we'll be learning in the day-to-day sessions. Okay, so this is the important explorer. So in this, so any new things you want to generate inside the application will be creating from the application explorer only. And records explorer is only for view purpose. See here what are all the categories we have, right? So all those things in organized in alphabetical order, it will display all those things. We cannot generate or we cannot create any new things from the records explorer, but only these are read only things. Okay, so any new thing if you want to create, we can create from the application explorer. And this again private, which is there in the header panel. And favorite is nothing but if you want to bookmark any rule in the application, so we can add it to the favorite category. Actually in all the previous versions we'll have only application explorer only will be there. So even though, so we have all these things in the latest version, so all these records, private, favorite, data, cases and recent are all included in the new version. We don't have all these options in the previous version. So only thing available in the previous version is only application explorer will be there. Okay, so these are all some add-on things newly included in the latest version. So actually mostly in the current version we will use application explorer and cases explorer. Okay, remaining things are not much important. So because we will not use those, are only just add-on things. In order to fill the gap in this explorer panel, they have included all these things. Okay, generally in the real time we will mostly use application explorer and cases explorer. Okay, and coming to the work panel, so if you open anything inside the application, so it will automatically open inside the work panel. okay, where we can maximize, means we can expand and collapse that one. If you open anything from the application explorer or anything, so these things will open inside the work panel. Okay, so inside the work panel only we'll design everything, we'll configure everything. If you want to expand, we can expand this work panel. So just click on this, double click on that, so we can expand that, and whenever it is done, so we can collapse that one accordingly. Okay, so and footer panel contains all the toolbars, so different types of toolbars will be there. So which are used for, so debugging, so some are debugging tools will be there, performance tools will be there, user interface debugging tools will be there. Okay, so these are all the toolbars we have in the footer panel, so which can be used for different purposes. So some are used for debugging, some are debugging tools, some are user interface debugging tools, performance tools, alerts tools. So these are all the tools which have in the toolbar panel. Okay, so these are all the components which have in the, so whenever you open the application portal, so these are all the things will be displayed by default. Again, inside each option will be having so many options will be there and so many parameters will be there. Okay, so from tomorrow, so this application setup will be starting. So from this, so if you want to start a new application setup, so we have to start from the application menu, so new application only. Okay, so meanwhile I will cover the installation procedure now. So I told you the system requirements for installing the Pega software is, so any Windows OS, so Windows 7, either go with premium or ultimate, okay, 64-bit OS. And coming to Windows 8 and Windows 10, so any version, so make sure it must be 64-bit, okay. So either any Windows version, it must be 64-bit operating system. And RAM size is minimum 4 GB RAM. And in the drive, any drive, either it is, for example, if we have more than one drive, like partitioned into different drives, so any drive you can install. Okay, so make sure 15 to 20 GB free space is there in the drive. Okay, so generally you'll get a file which contains some 2.6 GB to 2.7 GB file will be there. So we have to download that file. Okay, and just extract the software. So it will be having some different types of files, 7 to 8 files will be there. So when you open the folder after extracting the software, okay, so before that one more point is, see, generally when you place the, when you extract the software, right, so don't give any spaces to the folder name. Okay, so for example, if you give a folder name like this, Pega software with spaces, see, generally if you give any spaces to the folder name, it will not read the executable files. Okay, so the folder name should not contain any spaces. What are the files you are placing, right? Okay, please mute your microphones, somebody. Please mute your microphones. See, what are the folder name you are using, right? So that folder name should not contain any spaces. Okay, so that is important point. And if you have any higher versions of JDK version, means along with this Pega software, it will install Java also. Okay, I told you, if you have higher version, more than 1.7 version, yes, meet a microphone, 7. Somebody logging from the phone, meet a microphones. Okay, if you have higher versions of Java software, right, so before starting the Pega installation, so try to remove them. If you want, we can install it again later. Okay, means that is, if you have JDK 1.8 version, means, so uninstall that one. Okay, so again, after the Pega setup is done, you can reinstall it again. Okay, so and databases, if you have, also not a problem with the 7 version. And along with the, means, so once extracting the software and opening the folder, right, you'll get one option called install.batch file. So just click on that file and just start, click on next, next and start option. So at the time of starting the setup, right, you'll get a database. It will ask for the database port number and server port number. Anyway, by default it will take only, but the thing is, sometimes if you have any other servers or any databases installed, so then you can check whether the database port is available or not and server port is available or not. So there will be one button will be there, click on check port availability. So just click on that button, and if both the ports are available, you can continue starting the setup. If any of the port is not available, means we can enter different port numbers. So by default it may take 9090, so or it will take 5432 or 5434 it will take. Okay, this total setup will take around 30 to 35 minutes, and generally firewall some pop firewalls is enabled, means sometimes it will throw some firewall pop-ups. It will throw, just click on allow access. Okay, click, don't click on don't allow. So click on allow access for a couple of times. Okay, so then the installation will complete it automatically within 30 to 35 minutes. And once for the first time, right, when you install the product, the software for the first time, by default it will start the server automatically. Okay, it will start the server automatically. Then make sure Internet Explorer as a default browser. So even though if you open in other browsers also not a problem. And one more thing is, if you are having Windows 10 operating systems, anybody uses Windows 10 means, so generally in Windows 10 Microsoft Edge is the default one. Okay, so in Edge browser few things will not open, so maybe sometimes tool Pega application also will not open. Okay, if you have Windows 10 operating system, so generally Edge is a default browser, so make sure make Internet Explorer a default browser and open the application inside the Internet Explorer only. Okay, so now automatically, so once the installation is done, it will open the login page. Okay, and we have to enter the default username and password and check with the setup. Okay, if you are able to open the login page, means so you are successfully installed the software. Okay, if you are not able to open the login page and you are getting some server error message, means so there is some problem with the installation. So generally we can reinstall the setup once again. Okay, if so generally if you want to know whether the installation is successful or not, means so after starting the server, so just check or click on the login icon, and if it opens the login page, then it is successfully installed. Okay, if you are unable to open the login page, if you get any error messages, then some problem, so we can reinstall again, or so we can see what is the problem with the installation, we can see. Okay, so because so before starting the setup, make sure your systems are compatible or not, because if you try to install in 32-bit OS, means it will not install. Okay, make sure it must be 64-bit OS is mandatory. Okay, so this is mandatory. And sometimes if you have Windows 7 any starter versions, okay, so if it is home basic, it will install sometimes. So if you have, anybody is having home basic version also, try to install. Okay, if it is not working, then upgrade to premium or ultimate options, like professional or ultimate versions. And Windows 8 and Windows 10 by default you will get a 64-bit only, no problem. But Windows 7, if you have any starter version or home basic, means give it, starter version will not install, home basic 64-bit means you can give a try. Sometimes it will work and sometimes it will not work. If it is not working in Windows 7 home basic 64-bit version, so try to upgrade to professional or ultimate versions. Okay. And anybody is using Mac operating systems, so inside a Mac operating system, so some third party VMware you can install, and inside that you can install any Windows version. Okay, then we can install the Pega software. Okay, so directly we cannot install on Mac, so install the VMware, third party VMware, and inside that we can install this, we can configure this Pega software. Okay, so any questions on this installation? Okay, anyway, and one more thing is, from tomorrow, so only enrolled people only will get the link. So make sure, because we have other students are waiting for this time. So who enrolled for by end of the day, who will enroll for the sessions, they will only get the meeting link. Okay. So if you have any coordinators, so contact them. So then only you'll get the meeting link for tomorrow's session. Okay. So after paying the fees, you'll get the software and all. Okay. So meanwhile, any questions technically? Just tell me, Pam. Yeah, I will share the link for you. Okay. Yeah, server application server will be there. Yeah, client server architecture will be there. Okay, it will be there in the Pega systems. In the means, if you work on the companies, it will be there in the Pega systems. So the server will be located with, because it's not open source, right? So Pega systems will have the server. So from there they will get the license. The companies and clients will get the license. So they will provide the license for the remaining clients and companies. So that's what. So once they get the license, they'll get the software. Because, So this based on the means how many clients want to use and how many projects they want to develop. So the accordingly the license cost will be there here. And suppose only 100 developers want to use this application means. So this license will be, they will pay it for 100 members, and how many like 10 projects they want to use. So they will pay the license, means they will pay the cost for the 10 projects. So like this, so just they have to renew the license every time. So whenever they want to. Yes, like, so like couple of years it will be there. So after every couple of years they have to renew the license. Yeah, yes, client environment, yes. Okay. Yeah, it's like a process commands, it's a platform, we can say. Means you can see, right? So once after logging to this tool, so in this tool we can see all the options. Okay, again when you open anything, you can see all the widgets and all are configured in this commander, process commander. So those things is like a, you can assume it as a like a functional area, so which contains all the tools and all the options. Okay, once we define any new things inside the application, right? So once the application setup is configured, Pega will generate something called rule set. Okay, so inside the rule set, all the application, what are the rules we create inside the application, everything will be stored inside the rule set. So again, which is nothing but a workspace, we can say. So yeah, it will directly store in the server. Yeah, developing kind of thing. So once we set up the application, right? So in tomorrow's session I'll tell you. So this will configure automatically. It means what are the application name you give, with the same name it will configure something called rule set. So once application setup is done, so any new things you are creating inside the application, everything will be stored inside this rule set only. Okay. So that configuration and terminologies I will cover in tomorrow's session. So something called rule set. What is rule set? What is case? Okay, what is process? What is a class? So all these things we'll get in tomorrow's session. Okay. Yeah, see, portals are common in common. See, the look and feel will be common. So, developer portal and sysadmin portal both are common. Okay, so just you can access if you learn 7 or any version. So, but if you learn 6.3 directly, we cannot work on 7. Okay, but if you learn 7, yeah, actually we'll be using 6.3 also for a few topics and few scenarios. So then I will show all the options. Yeah, we'll follow the content. Okay. Okay, you ask your coordinator, I don't have the email IDs. So once ask them, they'll forward it to you. Okay, I will share by two. Yeah, I will share anyway. So same, a cost and all, you can ask your training consultant, they'll tell you. So from tomorrow session, so from today normally the same time, sessions will be same time daily, 6 to 7.30 it will be actually from tomorrow, 6 to 7.15 it will be from tomorrow's session. Okay, it will be 6 a.m. IST, it will be for 30 to 35 hours. So it may take 30-35 days it will take. Yes, yeah, we can use. Yes. One second. Yes, tell me, I can hear you. Yes, tell me, who is this? It's a full version here, not a trial version. Okay, yes, tell me. Yeah, I can hear you, tell me. Okay, I will share the recording of the session, okay. The same time, 6 a.m. IST. 6 a.m. IST. Yes. Now today is over. Just I'm taking the IDs today. So today is the first session. Newly joined there. I'm taking the IDs, email IDs and all. Okay. I'll tell. Okay. I will share the software to you for all of you. Okay, you'll be getting you'll be getting from the drive, Google Drive. I'll be sharing the link so you can download the software and you can save it in your systems. And it's a full version only, it's not like a trial version. So you can install that one in your systems. It's a full version only. Directly also you can, but try to use for better audio and video. Try to use any headset or earphones. It will be fine. you can use any headset or earphones. Mobile earphones also you can use. Headset or earphones. Yeah. Yeah. Oh no, not an issue. It will open in any browser. Or else, better use Chrome. Yeah, it will open in any browser. Not an issue. Okay. Name, please. Okay, tell me. Yeah, all are same only. So what are the things you said? All the three are same. In Pega. Okay, others please mute the microphones, please. So I'll tell name by name, then you can ask me questions. Who is Ananya? One by one I will ask you guys. So others mute the microphone. Ananya, just any questions? Chanakya, any questions? Okay, you are from? Yes, tell me. Yes, tell me, Santosh. Yeah, it will be purely certification based only. So once after completing the course, you can easily clear the certification. Try to use a, just if you have any problem like that, just rejoin again. Okay? Because you joined in the middle of the session, right? If you have any problem like that, just rejoin again. Okay? It will be clear. And what is your email ID? Email address. Because you are, see, don't try to join from phones here. So you'll get a meeting link, right? So try to install a desktop version of GoToMeeting and join. It will be clear. You will not face any issues. So when you try to join from phone, the desktop version of GoToMeeting will install. Okay, tomorrow's session I'll show you that one. Okay. So normally you'll get one icon in the desktop, right? So once if you install the GoToMeeting software in your systems, so if you join from the desktop version, you will not face any issues. I will share the desktop version link also. Everyone can install in the systems. Okay, try to log in from that version. It will be fine. Okay, share your email ID, Santosh. Email address here. Yes, tell me. Or else send your test mail to PegaBPM7. So I don't have all your email IDs. Okay, it's better everyone send a test mail to PegaBPM7. BPM7@gmail.com. Gmail.com. Okay, just see my screen. You can see on the screen. By afternoon you'll get, since my 7 is the time right now, by 11 o'clock you'll get the recording. Okay, next others. Madhu, who is Madhu? Madhu, any questions? Next. Manish, any questions? Yes. Okay, in the real time, the login option will be from the network which will be there. So different companies uses different ways, like single sign on they will use. Some companies use a Cisco networking tools they will use. So there no need to start the server every time. Server will be always it will be started. So just they'll use some tools for logging option. So like single sign on. So LDAP login will be there. Some companies uses. Some companies uses a Cisco networking tools they'll use. I will tell the options, possible options, what are the options we have, I will tell you. Yeah. Next, others, any questions? One second, next. Who is Raghavendra? Yeah, we have connectors, we have. Okay, we can migrate or we can map using from one application to other application. So not only documents, so entire application mapping also we can do. Yeah, we are going to configure one new application. Yeah, so other servers and other application tools also we can map, because Pega already having some internal connectors and services are there. We can use them like different types of services like Java, .NET, SAP and SQL. In SQL means it, any external databases, like mostly SOAP services mostly we will use. So we can map to any different applications. And from different applications, we can map to Pega systems. So all those things is possible. Yeah. Next, others, any Ramani, any questions? Yeah, it will be Monday to Friday. Yeah, 1 hour and remaining time 15 to 20 minutes. Any doubts or anything, I will take. Yeah, hands on. Yes. Yeah, maximum all the sessions will be hands on only. Yes. Yeah, I will share today. Okay, your email ID? Okay, fine. Next, Ravi, any questions? Ravi, any questions? Next, Jagadish, any questions? Next, Saujanya, any questions? Okay. Next, Sudhir, any questions? Sojin and Sudhir, your email IDs. Okay, Neelin. Okay, fine. Okay, fine. Sudhir, you are from Ashok, right? Yes, tell me, Jagdish. Okay. Yeah, I will share. Next, Sudhir. Sudhir, your email address? Okay, fine. Vandana, any questions? Any OS, it will be same. No, there will not be any difference here. Any OS is same. Okay, not required. It will be fine. Windows 7 will be good. No problem. You can switch to 10 also. 10 also it will be fine. Okay, except yeah, it's your wish. Okay, you can go with 8 or the 10. It is not. There will not be any issue. Both will be same. Okay, fine. Vandana, Vasundhara, any questions? Next to Venu, Vijay. Yes, tell me. Yes, tell me when. Means application access means nothing, but in the real time how it will be means. So based on the module, for example, suppose if one module is there, means few developers will be working on that module. Some other module is there, other set of developers will be working on that module. So the for example module 1 is there, right? So these people, set of developers, only can access the module 1. They cannot access module 2. But some team leader is there, means he can access module 1 and module 2. So like that, they will provide the access. Yeah, that depends. Means fresher, because so fresher, for the fresher is there, means they will give only the developer role. They will give some admin level and yeah, development only. But here roles will be different, right? So in the admin also, again we have some different roles will be there. High availability administrator, security administrator. So those tasks and all, they will not assign to developers, normal developers. So suppose no, the portal will be same for all, but while accessing the rules, right, they cannot create those rules. See, the portals will be, for example, okay, I'll tell you in tomorrow's session. For example, class creation is there. Suppose if you want to add a new class inside the application, so the new class creation can be possible only for security administrator or high availability administrator. Okay, if basic sysadmin access, they cannot create a class. So like that, so they will set access, means the business analyst will decide all these things. So what are the access they has to give for that particular developer, accordingly they will set the roles. Means I mean to say, the point here is the roles may differ from developer to developer. So that's the point. So, okay, if 10 developers are there, so for all the 10 developers, the roles will not be same. It may differ. That's the point. Yeah. Next, Vijay and Vigandar, any questions? Yeah, yes, not Unix. It may be Windows only they'll use. Most of the Pega applications will use Windows only. Windows environment only. Most Pega applications, Unix also supports. Unix supports, Linux also supports, but maximum they'll go with Windows only. So all the companies will use Windows environment only. Client and server, both is, yeah, both are Windows. So very rarely they use Unix or Linux. Okay, and just please enroll for the sessions by tomorrow, because by end of the day you'll get the meeting link only who enroll for the sessions. Okay, so contact your training coordinators. Okay, so from tomorrow, so we'll start a project. So we are going to start our project and start the process also. So practicals and all will start from tomorrow session. Yes, tell me. Yes, Chandrasekhar, tell me. So, okay, you will get the details today. So, phone details and all I will share. Okay, fine. So not now, after 10 a.m. IST you can. 10. Thank you everyone. Okay, yes, tell me Vijay. Yes, tell me. One second, can you repeat 1 second? Okay, fine. Okay, so thank you, everyone. We'll see tomorrow.